our top 10 videos are very popular. So here is the next one about Power BI. 10 things you must know. First one, the moment someone says Power BI, people are thinking about the paid version of Power BI. Remember that Power BI comes in free version as well as paid version. The free version itself is very powerful. So how do you install it? Go to Windows Store and install it. There are two apps there, don't get confused. Use the Power BI Desktop app. The benefit? It auto-updates. If you already have Power BI Desktop installed, no problem. Go to Help, About and make sure you have the latest version. So Power BI Free is free for life and it's extremely feature-rich. What is the difference? Here is a summary, but you will get details about how to use Power BI Free legally in this blog article. Link is in the description. Second one, whenever you start Power BI Desktop, the startup screen comes. Now, initially when you're learning, it's a good thing to have because it shows you tutorials, what's new. But when you're used to it, it comes in the way. So at the bottom, there is a small little checkbox which disable and it won't show again. Now, suppose you want it back. Oh, go to File. It's called Getting Started. The next one is about preview features. You may not know, but Power BI was introduced in 2011 and consistently every month, lots of features are added. New features are always in preview and then they get finalized. And they are great features. They are not just new features, they are simplifying existing features as well. So it's in your interest to enable preview features. How do you do that? File, Options, again Options, Preview Features, and I would say enable all of them. If you don't use Spanish language, then you don't require this one. Now, many of these features are great. You need to learn them. Each one of them has a learn more option after that. And many of them require you to restart after the setting is done. So enable all preview features. Next one is absolutely essential for people who are used to Excel. It's called On Object Interaction. It's one of those settings in preview features right now. Soon it'll get finalized. Now, I'll show you the difference. If you don't have On Object Interaction on, then when you want to create a Power BI visual, you see a visualizations pane. Now you create a visual, then it'll show you all the places where you can drag drop fields. These are called field wells. And then when you want to format, you click on the visual, there's a separate button for formatting and then lots of formatting options. Now this is something which Power BI has always had for so many years. But wait, if you're coming from Excel, this is non-intuitive. So enable On Object Interaction. Restart and now let's see how to create visuals. Exactly like Excel, now you have Insert Menu, Home tab, you have a list of charts available, visuals available, choose. Now each of the field wells directly gives you a list of fields, which is convenient. And from formatting point of view, right click, choose format. Now you get a blue border. Now you are in format mode. So like Excel, right click on any object now. Now you can see format data, format axis. So it's much more convenient and familiar like Excel. So use On Object Interaction. One of the commonest mistakes we do is use the default theme means fonts and colors. Now remember, you are part of an organization. You know what kind of logo you have, what color scheme you use. Many of the organizations have their branded templates and brand guidelines. If you want to customize, what do you do? Go to Power BI, create a dashboard that will use the default theme. Now go to the View tab, open the drop-down and just click on each theme and see how it looks. Maybe there is an existing theme which matches your color scheme, in which case start using that as a default. Now, most probably your brand colors will not match with the Microsoft standard themes. No problem. Choose any theme, go to Customize, and now you can choose brand colors, font, sizes, look and feel. Save that theme once and for all. Share it with everyone, and now all your reports will be on brand. The sixth one is about calculations. Like Excel, Power BI also has a set of 250 plus functions. They are called DAX and they are considered to be very complex, but don't worry about that. Whenever you import data and look at the fields, you will see sigma sign next to them. When you drag drop a field like that, by default it will do sum. We didn't ask it to do sum. That is called an implicit measure. But from a DAX point of view, if you want to use the calculation engine well, it makes sense to create our own measures. Do not use the implicit measures. Why? For now, trust me, I'll create a separate video for that. Now, what if I want average sometimes? What if I want count, distinct count? Every time I'll have to do sum and then do manual customization to choose. Instead, create a new measure. So now I'm creating a new measure. And what is the formula? Simple. I'm calling it total sales, and this is the formula. Similarly, I'm going to create another measure called average sales. Now we have a direct method of putting sum and average, so we don't want to see the implicit field at all. So right click on it and hide it. Now you can use explicit measures instead of implicit measures. One of the commonest mistakes I have seen people do is they create great reports in Power BI, take a screenshot and paste it in PowerPoint. Now what is the point? There is no power there. When you run the PPT, it's an image. You have no interaction. And interactivity is the key part of Power BI. And it requires Pro Plus or Office 365 version of PowerPoint. But if you have both, you get amazing benefit. So step one, create a report in Power BI Desktop. Publish. When you publish, you will get a link. Click on the link, it will open the same report on browser. Now go to PowerPoint. Add a new slide. In Insert menu, you should see a Power BI icon. In case you don't see it, install it as an add-in. It's free. Now paste that link here. And now when you run this presentation, it's not a static picture. You can do all kinds of interactivity during a PPT. It's an amazing feature which suddenly improves your presentations and data analytics. We just published a report, right? But along with the report, the data set also gets published. You of course created a report and published it. Excellent. But sometimes we need to create a report in Excel based on the same data. Now, why do you want to take the trouble of importing and cleaning it up again? The same data set can be used in Excel. Many people don't know how to do it. So let me show it to you. Go to the publish report and then click on this and say view data set. In the file menu, choose settings. Scroll down and go to endorsement section. By default, it will be none. Make it promoted and discoverable. That's it. Now go to Excel, and this has to be Office Pro Plus version, of course. Go to Excel. Don't import the raw data now. The data is ready in Power BI. Go to Data from Power BI, and then there you will see all the data sets. Search for this data set and directly create a pivot table. What's the benefit? Next time the data changes, some cleanup happens, refresh happens, the data set is already published. Now you go to this Excel file and just say refresh. So create data set once and use in Power BI as well as Excel. One of the mistakes which I've seen many people do is because they learned Power BI in Power BI Desktop, they continue to import data on Power BI Desktop. That's not needed. If you're Power BI Pro, then you can import data directly on the service, that means on the cloud. This is especially important when your data source itself is on the cloud. Nowadays, all our files are on OneDrive, Teams, SharePoint, that is online. So why import it on desktop? Go to the workspace, create a new data flow. Now, mind you, this requires a pro version. And import tables, it will show you the same familiar list of connectors. Connect to the data source. And then Power Query is available on cloud, exactly the same Power Query. So now dataset is ready. Now you can consume it in Power BI Desktop, Service or Excel. Again, reuse. And refreshing is much simpler because now desktop is not involved in refresh. Best of all worlds. Finally, all of us create reports and share it with others. Suppose the report is public. Public means you want people in the world to see it. Maybe it's your customers, dealers, distributors, whoever. There is another way of publishing it. That's called publish for web. So first of all, create the report, then publish it on the cloud as usual. Now go to file menu, go to embed and choose publish for web. It's written there, public. Now it will give you a code. Just share that code anywhere you want with anybody whom you want. Now what happens? The other party just clicks on the link and they will see your report with full interactivity. Remember, they will not have access to the data, but there is no authentication. Anybody in the world can see the report. I have covered free as well as paid versions. First, try the free features, get the benefit, and then explore the paid version. Have I missed something? Let me know in comments. Are there any queries? Also put it in comments. I will be happy to answer all queries. And before you go, If you are new to Power BI, don't get confused. There is a detailed Power BI for beginner tutorial. Have a look at it. That's it for now. Thank you.